Shout out to Aaron. He chose and made a donation for Neil Peart. I hope I said that right. Drum solo, Rush, live in Frankfurt. Here we go. This doesn't get blocked. It's not just, yeah, I just hope not, because everything runs through like a computer system on YouTube, and if they hear too much of what's already been copy, you know, written, you'll get in trouble. I'll get warnings through email and stuff. Hopefully just a warning. So let's read some comments. Otherwise I would just let this play the whole way through, because that was amazing. Your favorite drummer's favorite drummer. Nice. Imagine being this guy's neighbor. I bet you the neighbors are happy. He looks so damn unimpressed. Is this not his final form? That's clearly fake. The drums are paid actors. Nice one, Matthias. Matthias. Imagine being this good at something, anything. No, Anonymous Rabbit, I can't. He kind of looks like Tom Hanks. Okay, Bison's life. Benson in real life. Pizza sub. Any of y'all just realize the drum solo from Regular Show was based off of this? Is it? I don't even know what that is. Regular Show solo was a tribute to Neil. What happened? Okay, they're just like fighting. I don't wanna. Drum, Forrest, drum. I want a movie about Rush with Tom Hanks in a lead role, in a leading role as Neil, as narrator telling the story of Rush. Nice, Adam. Love the other kids who are wannabe drummers in here saying this ain't difficult and then never backing it up. Exactly, free kickers. Chad Smith and Will Ferrell should have a drum battle with Neil and Tom Hanks. Yes, they should. Okay, I love that. Pack up a little bit. And you guys, I am wearing my invisible headphones. See how it goes all the way around my ear? Yeah. Yeah. Let's go. few more comments and then I'll just let Neil go. Who was thinking about that one regular show episode when Benson had that epic drum solo? You know what? I've never seen that. Drum levels. Lars Ulrich, beginner, intermediate, advanced, expert, professional. Mike Portnoy, impossible god, Neil Peart. The most amazing thing to me is when he is playing the tambourine, with his left foot while doing everything else. Shout out to you, Mads. He doesn't miss a beat and stays on time the whole way. I've always considered myself an above average excellent drummer. Then I watch this video and reality smacks me in the face. That was cool for you to say. Neil is basically so awesome that he can make an entire swing band play by hitting his drums. This is a real drum circle, unlike those. Okay. Sounds like something you would hear in the background of a flash game in a jungle setting. Easily, without a doubt, the best drummer of all time. It's his precision, not a single hit too early or too late, simply amazing. The dexterity that he has, just that he can make those sounds, so. I mean, just timing everything. It's incredible. Taken from the RS magazine, when Neil auditioned for Rush in '74, his bandmates heard in him a chance to embrace their diehard Who fandom. We were so blown away by Neil's playing, guitarist Alex recalled in an interview earlier this year. It was very Keith Moon-like, very active, and he hit his drums so hard. Ironically, Neil's great contribution to rock drumming would turn out to be the exact aesthetic opposite of Moon's, the most precise and meticulously plotted percussion that the genre has ever seen. As Rush's high prog ambitions flowered in the mid to late 70s, Peart revealed himself as both an obsessive craftsman and wildly ambitious artist, traits that also surfaced in his fantastical lyrics using esoteric implements such as orchestra bells, temple blocks, and timpani to flesh out his baroque parts for songs such as Xanadu and The Trees. As the band's music streamlined in the 80s through transitional masterpieces such as Moving Pictures and onto a more pop-oriented sound, so did Peart's playing. He began tastefully incorporating electronic percussion and looking to mainstream innovators such as Stuart Copeland for inspiration. Rush's recent work, such as 2012's Clockwork Angels, features some of Peart's best work on record, a stunning unity of brains and brawn. Meanwhile, despite his recent retirement from touring, Peart remains perhaps the most revered and air drum too, live sticksman in all of rock, famous as the architect of literally show-stopping set piece solos. Bravo, Christian. Wow. Let's go. Let's finish this. Let's go back. And remember, I have my invisible headphones. Let's go. We'll be right back. That's it. Flawless. How he did that. Amazing. Wow. I can only be in awe. I have none of this talent. I'm nobody to critique him. I would never think of doing such a thing. I'm just here to observe and appreciate. Thank you so much, Aaron, for giving me this opportunity to watch this and just show my gratitude for such an amazing artist. I don't even know where to begin. It's incredible. Incredible. It's really something to watch musicians with their instrument. It is, oh my. Okay, thank you. We gotta keep going. We got many, many requests. Fantastic, though.